Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm feeling a little bit trepidant about the topic today because depending on which side of the website you sit on, you might find the topic today slightly sensitive. We are going to be talking about pop-up opt-ins for our website. As a consumer, as you're going from website to website, I'm sure they irritate you, but as a content marketer, as an online professional, they are a godsend. So we're going to be exploring those on growing your YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers on Dotto Tech. Yes, indeed. In my journey to growing my YouTube channel to 100,000 subscribers, I made a discovery fairly early on, which I'm sure you are all aware of, that my subscribers are YouTube's customers. They aren't my customers. Just like your followers on Twitter are Twitter's customers, not yours, and your followers on Facebook, as they let us know in no uncertain terms, are Facebook's customers, not ours. These people do not become our community until they sign up for our newsletter, get on our mail list, get into our system. So that is a goal. As a matter of fact, I probably think more about how to get people onto my into my system, into Infusionsoft, than I think about anything else. Coming up with good lead magnets, good offers for them to come on board that are relevant to the different segments that I want to promote. That's essential. And I've seen the results when I've launched products, and I've seen the benefit in sales by having a great, vibrant, healthy mail list. And we get that by getting the right people opting in at the right time. And one of the techniques that we do is these pop-ups. Now, I understand the sensitivity. In one aspect, we think, oh, we're invading their time and their space. We're kind of pissing some people off. I don't like it when I go to a site to read something and these things are constantly popping up. Fair enough. But if you are a valuable content creator, if you're creating good content marketing materials and giving away lots of free content, is it really that much to ask for a few seconds for you to close a box or to enter your email address in order to join the community if that's the proper thing to do? I think the risk that we run of estranging the odd person is far less than the damage we do to ourselves by not inviting people to our mail list and growing our business properly. And you have to ask yourself this. If somebody's that cheesed off by you popping up a little message inviting them to sign up for your newsletter, are they ever really going to be your customer anyways? Highly doubtful. So I think that it's something that you have to come to terms with yourself as far as comfort. And I had an internal dialogue. I went back and forth. I went, I'd like to be able to do it without it. But at the end of the day, the early numbers, as I've just started doing it, tell me that I should have done it much earlier. So you have that conversation, but you're probably going to end up where I am at some point. So I chose the tool OptinMonster for mine. There's a variety of different ones. AppSumo, there's a lot of different good pop-up managers that will help you out. And most of them have, I can't say for sure, but I know OptinMonster has two different aspects. It's a WordPress plugin, and it's also a web client that we work with. So here's the web client running here. Let's just jump into it. And you can see that I've set it up, and I haven't had it running for very long. Really, only a few days for some of my opt-ins and a little bit over a week for the others. But oh my goodness, I wish I had done it earlier. Here's my different opt-ins. Now, they don't necessarily all have to be those sorts that just pop in and kind of invade your space. You can also have bars that happen. You can have inline ones. I'm running an inline opt-in for all of my blog posts. So you can create all different sorts. But it looks to me like all of the PR that I hear about this stuff is accurate. That the pop-up ones, the ones that invade the space and get right in your face, they convert at the highest rate. So I'm running a widget one. I'll show you these in action in the website as well. I'm running my main Evernote Quick Start, which is for my kind of my main lead generator on my main page. I'm running a screencasting opt-in on all of my blog posts. And then I've got an inline one that's running at the bottom of all of my blog posts. Now, if you want to see how any of these look or how I create them, let's just take a look. This is the screencasting opt-in. If I click here to go into it, we edit it here within the web browser interface, and then we sync it with our WordPress install in order to transfer the information into WordPress. I will show you that in a moment. But here's the ad that I created to learn how I create these videos. And if we scroll down here on the left-hand side, we see the management area where we can choose different themes, which gives us different looks for each of them. You can choose how they are expressed as far as how they present themselves within the website. You can choose to have additional fields. I've got a name and email address, but you can also ask for first name, last name. You can just ask for the email address, and you can split test everything. Because if you say, for example, a great split test that I'm going to do very shortly is I'm going to have somewhere I ask for their name and email address, and the exact same ad only asking for their email address to see if that changes the conversion rate. You can split test everything in OptinMonster, which is one of the strengths, one of the reasons that I chose this tool. You've got in the configuration area, you determine exactly how the different offers are presented. You can set it by time. You can have them swing in as this one. You can have them slide in. You can have a variety of different ways for it to be presented, as well as an anticipatory exit. So when they see your mouse moving out of the window or moving towards the next page, at that point there it pops up, which has been proven to be a very valuable way of capturing people just before they leave your page for the next page. And again, you should be experimenting with each of those. The integration is, as you would expect, integration into your email autoresponder so that the all of the leads can be captured into the correct area. Analytics, as we go along, will mine it a little bit early, but you can integrate it with Google Analytics so that you can get much more data and you can make much more intelligent decisions about what you're doing. And then you can also target individual pages, individual URL slugs. So there's a lot of customization that happens. I won't go into all of those details, but instead let's jump into the website side or the web, the WordPress backend side, and we see all of these opt-ins resolved here. Now what happens is you create them all on the website and then you refresh the options here in WordPress and then it populates each of them in. When it populates them in, they won't be live, but instead what they will be is they will say that they're ready to go, and you have to go in and you have to basically go into their settings and you turn on and you have kind of a final setting, a series of selections that you do of determining, first of all, enabling it. So you have to basically turn it on and say we can start running it on the site. And then you've got a variety of options of where it's going to appear on your site. So this is kind of the final check that you have for your opt-ins before they go live on your pages. And then you save the settings and then they should start to run. So let's take a look at how they look as they're running. I'm just going to create an anonymous login so that because there's no cookie, so that it'll look like I'm coming for the first time. And I'm going to go to dottotech.com, and when we visit the site, my first pop-in is set to drop in 5 seconds after the page loads. So there's the page loading. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Boop. There it is, the Evernote Quick Start Guide. So, and I'll show you the results of this in a moment. I'll show you what the statistics are and how it's been running. But we see it's a straight pop-in, no animation, nothing like that. It's a quick little thing, and we can see the close button is easy to find, which gets us right back into our main content. If I scroll through and now I'm going to watch one of my blog posts, again, I've got a different opt-in that's set to run here. And I could actually set it up that if they've opted in on the first one, not to opt in on the second one, et cetera, and not to see the second one. But here's the second one dropping in. This is a format called a lightbox format, where you see it's kind of in a lightbox out in the foreground and then the background dims behind. So it's a very common way of doing it. But we can see the second one comes in, and I've got that little swing thing happening to draw the eye. I think this one looks pretty good, don't you? And it's got I like this one even better than the first one because it's got a very clean close box. Despite the fact that I'm encouraging you to think about doing this, I still feel a little bit guilty about doing it. But my guilt is being assuaged quite nicely by the number of people who are opting into my mail list. Thank you very much. So we've got that there. The other two styles that I've got don't pop up at all, but it's one of them is here, and if we scroll right down to the bottom, we see this sign up for Dotto Tech News, which is called an inline, which I've set for the bottom of every one of my blog posts. And the other one I've got is in my header, is in my sidebar. Now, my sidebars in my theme here actually are invoked by the person clicking on the little down arrow here. When you click here, you've got my different sidebar items. So I've got to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And here's the sign up. It's very simple and very plain for Dotto Tech News, but it's there in the sidebar as well, as well as right now I'm running an ad for OptinMonster, which, full disclosure, I've signed up to be an affiliate for. So if you do decide that you're going to purchase the product and you click on the link that I've included, I will be rewarded for that if you choose that. If not, just go search for them direct and you can go straight to their site if you don't think I should be paid. But really, why would you do that? Why? Now, it's all set up. Let's go back into the original document here, into the website, and let's take a look at my dashboard, and we can see the conversion rate. So we get an immediate statistics on how each of these is performing, and there's quite a wide difference. You're going to see that top widget opt-in, which you've seen, it's actually had quite a few people look at it. 859 people have looked at it, but only 7 people have converted to it, which is 0.081%. Not a very high percentage, but having said that, that's 7 people in the past week or so that it's been running that are on my mail list that wouldn't be on my mail list. So I'm not completely unhappy. Now, a lot of people have pop-up blockers running on their browsers, so that's where the discrepancy in numbers comes from. So 164 people have seen my Evernote Quick Start ad or pop-up, and 18 of those have converted to nearly 11%. This is phenomenal. This conversion rate to me is something that is going to ultimately make a big difference. If we think about this now being extended over weeks, months, and years, this is going to add hundreds or thousands of people to my mail list, which ultimately is just going to benefit me downstream financially and make my whole business that much healthier. The screencasting one, which has just been running for a couple of days now, has had 97 views and it's running at just over 5%. I'm thinking this is going to climb. This is going to increase, and I'm also going to kind of flip. As we're doing the screencasting course coming up soon, I'm probably going to flip this one to the home page and move this one into the second page and do those sorts of things and play around. You don't have to leave them where they're set up for all time. Here's the one that surprised me, the inline one, which is at the bottom of each of my blog posts. It's been viewed 3,400 times, so in the past little week and a bit. So 3,400 people have read our blog posts, seen the inline one. Now, more people will see that one because it's not a pop-up, so it's not being blocked by people's any ad blockers or pop-up blockers that people have running in their browser. But only 16 have converted, which is a big number overall, but it's less than half a percent of people who see it. So just putting an opt-in on your page regardless, which is all that this one really is never going to convert as well as it popping up in front of people's places. Do we need more proof than this? It's by a factor of 2,000% is how many more people. My math might be weak, but it's a heck of a lot more, as you can see. So the lesson is there for you to take should you choose to listen to it. If you want more people opting in on your mail list, set some sort of pop-up opt-in on your website. If you choose not to, fine, it's your choice. But if you choose to, success may be thine. I hope you found today's video to be useful. Now, there's 3 ways for you to stay in touch with us here at Dotto Tech. The first is, of course, subscribe to my channel. The second, ever more important than subscribing to this channel, subscribe to my newsletter. And I can send you information about our upcoming webinars, tutorials, courses. We have a screencasting course coming up in the not-too-distant future. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel supported by the generosity of our viewers through the crowdfunding site Patreon. Drop by the Patreon page, have a look, see how you help us create the videos and what we can give you in return. The perks are kind of amazing. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.